Pepsi you drink, the more great stuff you're going to get.
Play that again.
No fine print came up. I don't care what anybody else says. That is a legit offer.
In the 90s, Pepsi was famous for the advertising.
It was a cool club to be in.
Different world then, different John. This commercial comes on. Harrier Jet, 7 million Pepsi points. I really saw this as an opportunity to change my world. I'm like, I want the jet. My mind couldn't stop racing to try to figure out how to make this happen.
We just couldn't drink that much Pepsi.
I need to buy 1.4 million 12-packs. I knew there was one person that I could potentially get to bite on this.
And then he pitched this idea. It's crazy. It's insane.
Six warehouses, somewhere in the neighborhood of 45 people. It would cost $4.3 million. But I'm reading the fine print.
We found a loophole. Here we go.
Bring on Pepsi.
Hey, somebody sent us a check for $700,000 for the Harrier Jet.
What?
Why? 7 million points, Harrier Jet? You saw it.
It's clearly a joke.
This was a money grab opportunity.
Then they changed the ad.
We're just kidding here.
A big corporation knows how to game the system. I'd use different language if I weren't on camera.
You're on Netflix, so you can use whatever language you want.
Fuck them.
Pepsi went on the offense.
It was in no way an admission that we had done anything wrong.
It was an admission of guilt.
That was above my pay grade.
Legal will kill anything.
It was something right out of a Tom Clancy story.
I'm not going to prison over a damn jet.
We need to shake things up a little bit.
Plot twist.
Michael Avenatti. You can read all about him. Just Google his name.
This is when things really started to get crazy.
They never figured that there ever would be a John Lennon.
What do I have to lose?
You wanted that jet.
I want the jet.
Johnny wants the jet.